The global energy market is hotting up and the price of oil is surging. In recent weeks, the price of Brent crude has approached levels not seen since the start of the financial crisis back in 2008. OPEC countries have little spare capacity, and non-OPEC countries are struggling with supply disruptions. Demand for oil, meanwhile, remains surprisingly strong, given the uncertainty surrounding the global economy. And the high price of oil could have a big impact on the recovery.
We are spending more money at the petrol station, so we have less to spend in buying a plasma TV, for say something. At the same time, they will contribute to drive higher inflation, and that will reduce the room that central banks have to support the economy. And also, they are a very bad psychological element for the recovery. Gasoline prices in particular is something that we see almost on a daily basis or a weekly basis, and when prices increase, usually the confidence of consumers is reduced.
The rising oil price has led Saudi Arabia to expand production in an attempt to calm the market. The move had some initial impact. Oil has fallen back from $128 to $123 per barrel.
The oil market is focusing about Saudi oil. This is a barrel of Saudi oil from Saudi Aramco. And oil traders are looking for more of these small barrels coming into the market. So you could argue that the combination of increasing Saudi Arabia production, more barrels like this one going into the United States, more importantly, those comments by Saudi Arabia trying to toll down the market are beginning to have some impact. The problem is that if Saudi Arabia increases its production a lot, then the cushion, the spare capacity is going to be reduced, and that's usually a bullish factor.
So a fall in the kingdom's cushion of spare production could result in rising oil prices. And tensions between the West and Iran over its nuclear ambitions are exacerbating the situation too.
I don't see any sign that Iran is willing to curb in any significant way its nuclear program. The risk of an attack is coming from Israel. If there is a strike, we're not talking about just military attacks on nuclear facilities, because you could very well get retaliation that then draws in the US. And this is what the concern of the Americans is, that this is not going to be, we're not talking about a strike, we're talking about a war.
If there is a war, the consequences for the oil price and in turn the global economy would be devastating. It could result in the closure of the Strait of Hormuz and the loss of around 15 million barrels of oil, or 20% of the global supply. The situation has led some analysts to speculate that oil is at a tipping point, with Vitol, the world's biggest independent energy trader, warning that a rise to $150 a barrel isn't out of the question. Some are even warning that oil could be the new Greece.
Probably that's the Armageddon scenario. Something has to go wrong with Iran. But Vitol is warning that the $150 probably is the high side. But they are also saying that they don't see much downside to current prices and that prices are going to be holding around current levels of above $120. At current levels, oil prices are damaging for the global economy. They are a new factor that only 3 or 4 months ago was not there. And I don't think that we are yet on a situation where oil prices are the new Greece. But for sure, at these price levels, oil prices are a negative for global economic growth.
The key question in the markets is what's going to happen with the oil supply in 2012. All eyes are on the West diplomacy with Iran. Countries and companies, meanwhile, are preparing for the worst by hoarding supplies. But while that might sound prudent, it could only serve to tighten the market and further squeeze the oil price. Daniel Garahan, Financial Times.